Hi, welcome to Greg's Java. In this series of tutorial, I am covering equal and hashCode and HashMap. So I already covered the equal and hashCode with real life examples. And my last video was about the HashMap internal implementation, which I have explained also. So please check those videos first before directly coming to this video. You can also find all those videos from my channel. From the bottom of the video you are watching, just click on Greg's Java, okay, and then you will be routed to the channel. From the channel, just select the playlist, and from the playlist, just select Java top interview questions. And in this playlist, you can see all those video: HashMap internal implementation, equal HashCode contact, HashCode method gear use, and equal method detail explanation. And also you can subscribe the channel, just click on the subscribe button here in the bottom of the video you are watching, so you will get a notification once I upload a new video. This video is about HashCode and equal methods while we put or get values from the HashMap. So I will explain how it behaves. I have already created a sample class, a bucket class, in my last video. So in this class I have overridden equal and HashCode method. So first I'm going to explain what happened when we have not overridden equal and HashCode, both of the methods, and we are using HashMap, and we are actually using any custom class. Like bucket is a custom class which I have created, so I'm going to put this class as a key into the HashMap. So let's check this. So before that, let's add some value into HashMap. Let's check the functionality of HashMap. So suppose we have a map of string, key and values. Okay, so let's add a key as 1, 2, 3, and again put some duplicate values. Let's say we have a duplicate 3 as well and duplicate 1 as well. Okay, so we can print now, that we can iterate the map, and let's see the output. So in this map I have created 5 objects. 2 are duplicate, this 3 key and 1 is duplicated. So let's check out the output of map. Okay, so we don't have these. Okay, so let's run this. Okay, as we see the output, we have added 5 objects into the map, but we have only 3 objects. So we have a key 1, we have a key 2, we have a key 3. Okay, so let's add some space here such that it is more clear. Okay, let's run this again. The key which is already exist is replaced by the key with the latest value. Okay, so let's change the value of map. Okay, so now if we run this, so this value is replaced with this one, because these two keys are duplicated, so that's why the value which is latest one is replaced by the previous one. So same thing happened with key which have 1 as a duplicate. So here for 1 we have the last value, okay, this value. It means this first value is duplicated, this is replaced with the latest value. Okay, so that's the concept of map, how it works. So it means whenever we have a duplicate key, it won't be inserted again, it will be replaced by the latest value. Let's say we want to get a key which have 1, the first key. So we can do this. Let's say system.out.println map.get 1. We can pass the key. Okay, and let's run this. So we have the same output, this output for 1. So based on the key, we can get the value from the map. Okay. Inside map, we are using string as a key. That's why in the string class, so if you open the string class, in string class, we have overridden the equal and hash code methods. Okay. So let's see the equal method. Equals method, yes. So equals method is overridden in the string class, and also hashCode method must be overridden in the string class. Yes, so string class have overridden both of the methods. That's why when we put the any key as a string into the HashMap concept works. Okay, so this is about the string keys that I have added into the map. So let's say we have a custom object like a bucket object. So let's suppose we have a bucket instance as bucket b1 equal to new bucket. And add the height and width as well. Okay, so let's add some b2, b3, b4. Okay, and these two b1, b2 are same, and b3 have key as 1, 1. Okay. So these two objects b1 and b2 have the same values for height and width, and v3 and v4 as well have the same values. Let's cover the first point. If we have not overridden, then if we put some key into the map, so what happens? Let's remove this. Okay, let's comment this as well. And here let's put the values of bucket. This is b1, so we need to change here as well. Okay, put b2, b3, and b4. Okay. And let's print a bucket by getting based on the key. So here we can say we have we can say new bucket. So let's run this. Let's check the output, and also we need to print the height here. Okay, height and width t dot get key dot width. Okay, so let's run this. We can see the output. So I have not overridden the equal and hash code, both of the methods. So let's check the output. So we have 4 objects added into the map. Okay, all 4 objects are added. They have same height and width. these two objects are equal and these two are also equal, they have same height and width, but still they are added into the map because we have not provided any custom implementation of the equal method, and also we have not overridden the hashCode method. That's why all four objects are inserted into the map. Okay, and when we get a map based upon these values 10 and 20, we got nothing, so null. Okay, so it means if we don't override equal and hashCode both of the method and we put a custom object as a key into map, then the map concept won't work. Okay, so let's check out the second point. So here equal method is overridden but hashCode is not overridden. Okay, so let's override the equal method. Let's see the output. Okay, let's run this. So now equal method is overridden in the class. Same output. Okay, so it is giving same output because as we discussed the equal and hashCode contract in the last videos, equal and hashCode contract say if two objects are equal then their hashCode must be equal, and if two objects have same hashCode they may not be equal. So in this case what is happening, when we are putting a value into the map, it first calculates the hashCode. Okay, and based upon the hashCode it insert the values, and here when it get the values a new hashCode is provided for this object. So that's why it will not be able to find out this object that we are getting. Okay, so we need to override both of the methods to make it work. So as per our third statement here, when both of the method is overridden, so let's see the output if you override both of the methods. Okay, let's run this. Yep, so now only two object is added into the map. Okay, because as per our equal method implementation, if two objects have same height and width, it means those are equals, and we have also overridden the hashCode method. So that's why whenever we put a value into map, it first calculate the hashCode. Okay, and then again when the same value, same object come with the same height and width, it will not insert, it will replace with the previous object. It means B1 is replaced with the B2 object. Okay, same thing happened for B4 as well. So B3 is replaced with B4. So if you put B1 here, okay, B2 here. So if we run this, so we are getting second bucket. Okay, so if we change the value of this parameter, okay, this is first, this is second, let's say this is third and this is fourth. Okay, let's run this. This should return second. Yeah, it is returning second bucket. Okay, so now we have fourth statement. When the object have same hashCode but they are not equal, so let's check this. So as I have explained in my last video, these are the two objects example which have same hashCode. Okay, but they are not equal because they have different width and height. So if we check the hashCode of both of these objects, that should be equal. Okay, so let's check it. Check this P5 dot hashCode. Okay, Okay, and let's check the hash code for B6 as well. Okay, let's run this. Okay, so both of them has same hash code. So this is a collision. This is a chance of the collision. So let's test this. Let's put this value into map and we can verify the output. Okay, so this is B5, this is B6. Let's change this as well. C6 bucket. Okay, let's run this. So we have same hash code and let's check the map. Okay, so in map both of these objects are getting added. So 5th and 6th both of these objects are getting added. So whenever we have same hash code, then these two objects are getting added into the same memory location and a linked list is created for these two objects. After Java 8, it's a self-balanced tree. Okay, so all these four statements are covered. So we need to override both of the methods in our classes where we are putting a custom object into the hash map. That's I think all about the map with equal and hash code method. In my next video I will discuss other question, Java interview question. So thanks for watching. Bye bye.